Everyone, this is Nick. I got this viewer question on one of our shorts on just how to calculate things like the average, the median, the minimum, the maximum from a list of values inside of Excel. And this person comments, says it's showing them all as zeros when I do this. So in that video right here, let's just say in this column right here, column F, these are all the scores that we want to average and calculate the median, minimum, maximum, those kinds of things. And you can see right here, I'm gonna go ahead and you can see right here when I click in here, you can see the formulas that I put in, the functions that I put in here. So right here, look up here in the formula bar, it's average, it's averaging all of these numbers together. The median, it's calculating the median of this range of values, and then the minimum and the maximum, it's giving the min and the max. Now, if you're getting all zeros, what I would do is highlight these cells, go up to the number format menu right here. You can see it's formatted as number. Now, if I go ahead and format it as general, let's just play with this and see what happens. I'm going to play with it. I'm going to switch it to general. And now you can see all of those decimals pop up. Now the values are expanded a little bit. So what I'm thinking is maybe you actually had it set right here. You can decrease the decimal points or increase the decimal points right here under the number menu. So I'm going to go ahead and decrease the number of decimal points right here. My hunch is that you had it decreased so that there's no decimal point showing. And of course, all of the values that you were averaging or calculating might have been below that 0.5 number so that it's rounding down to zero. So just make sure to go ahead and increase it by at least one decimal point and you'll start to see those values, maybe two decimal points, and then you'll start to see those values again too. So I hope this helps and maybe that was the thing that would do the trick for you. So thanks again for the viewer question. If you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Had a great time making this for you. Can't wait to see you next time.